हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ सैयद अब्दुल्ला शाह खादरी फ्रॉम बीई मैकेनिकल सेकेंड ईयर। सो टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस। बिफोर मूविंग अहेड, लेट अस नो व्हाट फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस इज। इट इज़ अ मैकेनिकल प्रोसेस यूज्ड इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज वेर इन मटेरियल्स मोस्टली मेटल्स अंडरगो प्लास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशंस एंड अक्वायर रिक्वायर्ड शेप्स एंड साइजेस by application of suitable stresses such as compressive stress, tensile stress and shear stress. So this metal forming is divided into two categories. One is bulk deformation and another is sheet metal working. So in bulk deformation, significant shape change by deformation in metal parts whose initial form is bulk rather than sheet takes place. So and in sheet metal working, the forming operations are performed on metal sheets, strips and coils whose thickness is very low. So today let us discuss about bulk deformation. In this we'll discuss about rolling, forging, extrusion and wire and bar drawing operations. So now let us discuss about rolling process. In this bulk deformation process, the stock metal passes through one or more pairs of rollers which results in reduced thickness. So what this is the basic structure of rolling process. What exactly happens here is these two are rollers which rotate in opposite direction to each other. This rotates clockwise direction and this rotates in anti-clockwise direction. So when this stock metal passes through these rollers, due to this compressive stress induced in these rollers, it results in plastic deformation which results in reduced thickness. So the working is very simple, just a metal is passed through these rollers and due to this compressive stress, the thickness is reduced. So this rolling process is classified as hot working and cold working. As we all know, hot working means working the metal which is heated above the recrystallization temperature and it is worked. So in this cold working, the process happens below the recrystallization temperature. So in case of hot working, you need to heat the metal 50 to 100 degrees above the recrystallization temperature. Only then you can deform it. So this when this stock metal is heated above the recrystallization temperature, it gets soft. So when it gets soft, it is easily deformed plastically with less force requirement. So the applications of hot working are truck frames, pipes and tubes, water heaters. So in these things, these hot working is applicable in case of rolling. So let us come to cold working. So here the metal is deformed below the recrystallization temperature. So metal, the stock metal is not heated here, but in fact it is deformed at room temperature only. So it requires more force as it is hard enough, and it results in non-uniform thickness. So to get it uniform thickness, you need to add more pairs of rollers here. So the applications of cold working are metal furniture, home appliances, computer cabinets, fan blades, etc. So here these are the applications of cold working where you need not have that accuracy as compared to hot working. So in this case, hot working operation, you know, the uniform thickness is uniform and soft. So the grain structure is, you know, well refined. But in case of cold working, sometimes failure also occurs. Now let us come to extrusion process. It is the metal forming process where workpiece is forced to flow through die which reduces its cross section and it is converted into desired shape. So this is the basic structure of extrusion process. Here these are dies which are fixed and this is ram which is movable and is used to push the metal. So when this metal is placed inside the dies and pushed with the help of ram, it results in reduced cross section. The cross section depends upon the shape of the die. It not only reduces the cross section but can be achieved in desired shape. So if you change this shape of die to an I section, then you by application of this force you can obtain I section with this metal. So this is also similar to rolling operation, but rolling operation is applicable only for sheets, not for these I sections and all. So extrusion process helps to attain I sections and other other type of sections. So this extrusion process was also divided into hot working and cold working. As we all know, in hot working the metal is heated above the recrystallization temperature, and when this metal is heated above the recrystallization temperature, it gets soft, so less force is required to deform it plastically. In case of cold working operation, the whole process is carried out below the recrystallization temperature or at the room temperature, which is a somewhat difficult process because the metal is hard and more force is required to obtain the output. So in case of hot working process, when if you are working on magnesium metal, so the temperature which is suitable for working on extrusion process is 350 to 450 degrees Celsius. In case of copper, the temperature ranges from 600 degrees Celsius to 1100 degrees Celsius. And in case of aluminium, the temperature ranges from 350 degrees to 500 degrees Celsius. So this is the extrusion process. This is also similar to rolling operation. And the applications. So let us come to applications. Applications of extrusion process. So this is used to produce hollow pipes or tubes, and also it is widely used to produce plastic objects. It is mostly used in production of plastic objects because plastics are soft enough to deform, and metal forming and in this extrusion process the dies can be of varying sizes and shapes, so the plastic objects are very very much suitable for extrusion process. So now let us come to forging process. Forging process is nothing but shaping of metal by using compressive forces or blows which are delivered with a hammer or a die. So in this forging process, in this figure we can see the process of forging. So this is the fixed die, this is the movable die. So when workpiece is placed in between these dies, and with this movable die, force is applied on it, and due to this force, this workpiece deforms and it converts into desired shape and size. So in this forging operation, not only dies but compressive forces and also blows of hammer. So when compressive forces are used, when the metal is soft, and blows of hammer are used for small objects as well as large objects, but the metal is very hard in this case. So these forging operations are of three groups. One is drawn out operation. In this forging operation, the length of the metal increases and cross section decreases. So and another one is upsetting. Here length decreases and cross section increases. And another is squeezing operation, where metal is squeezed in close compression dies, which produces a multidirectional flow. And this forging operation is of three types. One is open die forging, and another is closed die forging. So this figure which I have showed you is a closed die forging, because these are the closing parts of a die where metal cannot come out after these two are in contact. So in case of open die forging, these are dies and the workpiece is directly deformed with the help of compressive forces. So this metal, there are chances of metal coming out here from here. So but in case of closed eyes, after this excess material comes out, no metal can be coming out because of this two parts which gets in contact and closes the direction of flow. So this is about forging. Now let us go to wire and bar drawing operations. So now let us discuss about wire and bar drawing operation. This is also a bulk deformation process where reducing of cross section of bar, rod or wire takes place by pulling it through a die. So let us understand the working of wire and bar drawing operation. This is also very simple operation. These two are dies which are mounted on a draw bench, and this is the workpiece. This can be of metal or plastic depending upon our requirements. So this workpiece is pulled out through these dies by the help of tensile forces so that its cross section decreases. This is also simple in working. But before feeding it to the die, sir, the workpiece end must be reduced in this manner so that it does not damage the dies. So in case of wire and bar drawing operations, bar drawing is carried out in batch mode and wire drawing is carried out in continuous mode. In case of bars, these are strong and cannot be wound around. This cannot be wound on something. So these need to be in batch mode. But in case of wire drawing, it is continuous mode because wires can be wound around something and it can be of large length. So this is wire and bar drawing operation. It uses tensile force to stretch the metal. So mostly copper, steels, aluminium and common material, these are the common materials that are used in wire and bar drawing operations. So by this I conclude my topics. So thank you.